Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm Courtney Ryan, and today I'm going to be going over how to take care of your clothes to make sure that you're not ruining them. I've done a good amount of videos on my channel about the things that you should be buying, some cool outfit ideas, but I've never done a video about how to properly take care of your clothes, which is part of the battle and ways to make sure that you're looking your best. So today I want to go over some things that you might be doing wrong, some mistakes you might be making that are destroying and ruining your clothes and preventing you from looking your best. So let's get started. And I guarantee a lot of you guys are making these mistakes because I have even been guilty of making these mistakes in the past, even though I went to fashion school and I'm an expert, so stick with me. Mistake number one is that you're using the wrong hanger. And I have been so guilty of this in the past. There was a video I filmed a couple weeks ago where I had hung my brand new sweater dress up on a hanger and it was the wrong type of hanger. I shouldn't have hung it in the first place, but it was on the wrong type of hanger. And when I went down to film my video, I had a pucker in the shoulder of my sleeve, and it was all I noticed the entire video. So believe it or not, the hanger that you use is incredibly important for the longevity of your clothing. And you want to make sure you're using the right hanger for the specific type of clothing. So just to give an example here, for a suit jacket, you should look for a fully contoured profile that mimics the outline of the jacket. So you're going to want to look for these wider shoulder flares, typically 2 to 2.5 inches for a suit jacket hanger. This one could even be a little bit thicker if I'm being honest. So you should look for these wider shoulder flares, 2 to 2.5 inches, and then this wire trouser bar in the middle for your matching trouser to go along with the jackets. A lot of guys make the mistake of putting their suit jackets on a flimsy plastic hanger, and it will ruin the shape of your jacket and make your shoulders look all wonky. So to keep that shape and to keep it looking its best, you want to use the specific type of hanger for the suit jacket. When it comes to your pants, jeans or more casual pants can be folded without creasing, but for all of your nicer, more elevated trousers, those should be hung from a hanger like this with a felt clamp on the hem to be hung out and totally elongated to get out all the wrinkles. So if you're going to fold a pair of pants like that, it should be over a felt bar like this. The felt and the thicker bar here is going to help prevent, you know, more creasing than like a regular hanger would cause. I would still not recommend this as much as I would recommend hanging them. They're just going to look a lot better, and that little pleat and crease in the front is going to stay in longer and just look a lot better and more structured. Your pants are just gonna look better if you hang them up because it's elongating them and helping get all of the wrinkles out. So I would recommend, even though you can, again, put them over that felt bar, I would recommend hanging them. When it comes to your sweaters and things like that, some sweaters should absolutely never, ever, ever be hung, which I'll talk about in the next section here. But there are specific types of hangers made specifically for sweaters. So if you're going to hang your sweaters, I would use those. Do not, again, like I said before with my sweater dress, do not use those cheap plastic hangers that you can get at Target. I am going to go through my closet and completely change all of my hangers because I have noticed that my clothes are slowly being ruined by the fact that I'm using these cheap hangers, because you really need to use the specific type of hanger that goes with the clothing that you're hanging up if you're going to hang it. So you can fold sweaters too if that's easier for you. I would mostly recommend doing that. And whatever you do, do not use those wire hangers from the dry cleaners. As soon as you get home, take those off and switch them to a better hanger, because those will also ruin your shirts. And mistake number two that you're making is you're hanging the wrong type of clothes. So things like t-shirts and polos and shirts made of a thinner cotton should be folded and not hung. They do make specific hangers for these again, but if you don't have those type of hangers, I would recommend folding. You don't want to stack these too high when they're folded because it can crush the ones at the bottom and cause wrinkling, but they are better off being folded if you don't have those specific type of hangers made for a thin cotton shirt. And I know I talked about how they make specific hangers for sweaters as well, but a lot of sweaters you're better off just folding, because if you're hanging them, it can often stretch out the fabric. So a shirt that was once at your hip will now be at your mid thigh a couple years down the road, and you might not even realize it. But it gradually is going to stretch out the fabric. So again, you might not realize it right when you put it on the hanger. You're like, everything's great, it looks awesome. But you might notice it the next time you put it on the next season, that it might have stretched out a little bit and it's a little bit longer than you remember it being. Because especially if it's a thicker sweater, a more heavy sweater that's hanging on the hanger, Things like your pants, you want those to be elongated, right? But your sweaters, you don't want to stretch out like that. So keep that in mind. My next little tip is to use a shoe tree. So your shoes naturally lose shape and crease over time. That's just kind of the natural progression of shoes. But by using a shoe tree, you can actually help prevent the creasing of the leather and have the shoe keep its shape. It's a little bit of a tongue twister there. So another little fun fact about shoe trees is that dampness in your shoes can actually cause lining to break. It smells bad. It might give you a little fungus surprise that you weren't expecting. So using a shoe tree can actually help prevent dampness and odor, which is great, obviously, for the life of your shoe and making sure it lasts as long as possible. If I were you guys, I would put these in your leather boots, your dress shoes, your leather sneakers that you don't want to crease and look really bad. These are just really going to help your shoe keep its shape and prevent all these little unfortunate events from happening with your shoes and making your shoes look a lot better and last a lot longer. So if you're investing the money in your shoes, I would also get these little shoe trees to make them look their best. And while we're on the topic of shoes, I wanted to also talk about shoe care because I feel like this is something that a lot of people neglect. Now, I know a lot of you are crazy particular about cleaning your shoes, taking care of them, making sure they look their best, but sadly, a lot of guys do not do this and it is very evident. So knowing how to care for different styles of shoes, whether it be using a polish, a moisturizer, a protective spray, whatever it is, just knowing how to care for the specific type of shoe you're buying is, again, going to help increase the longevity and life of your shoe. Different types of shoes and different types of materials on the shoe require different care to keep them looking their best. So I could honestly make an entire video of like different shoes and how to care for them. It's a little bit too long for me to talk about all of it today. So when you're buying your shoes, do your research to make sure you know how to take care of them, because if you don't, you're just going to be throwing away a ton of money. I'm telling you, half of the battle and half of your responsibility as a shoe owner is to take care of your shoes and your belongings. So for example here, if you buy a pair of suede Chelsea boots, you're going to want to spray those with a protective spray, especially if you live somewhere where it ever has bad weather, it ever rains. If you get suede wet or get something on your suede, it will absolutely ruin the shoe. Same thing goes for like a pair of UGG boots. I know you all think they're ugly, but they were like the hot thing to wear in eighth grade. And I had a pair and I didn't spray them with protective spray and they looked like absolute garbage. So if you're going to pay the money for an expensive pair of shoes, you better pay the $20 for a protective spray to protect them and keep them looking their best. Say you buy a really beautiful pair of brown leather dress shoes and you never take care of them. You never brush them, you never polish them or moisturize them. They are going to dry out, they're going to crease, they're going to look like crap. They're gonna be covered in scuffs and just not look like the pair of shoes you got when you bought them. So you're gonna wanna have a brush, a polish, a moisturizer. There are a ton of different steps to taking care of dress shoes and leather boots and things like that. Teddy has gotten really into it lately. We have a whole box of shoe care stuff now. Now, the difference it has made in the way his shoe looked before versus after, they look like brand new shoes. So you really want to make sure that you are properly taking care of your shoes, especially if you are investing in them and spending a lot of money on them. If you don't properly take care of them, they're just going to get ruined and they're not going to look good or stand the test of time. So again, before you buy a pair of shoes, can't get into every single shoe today, but before you buy a pair of shoes, make sure you did the research and know what you need to do to properly take care of them. And my last tip, which is one of the most crucial, is washing incorrectly. One thing to always make sure you do is read the care instructions. Even if you're someone who likes to cut the tags out of your clothes, I get it, they can be itchy sometimes, we gotta get rid of them. Make sure you put a note in your phone of the garment and then the care instructions that come along with it, because often we think we're gonna remember exactly how to wash it and we don't, and then we ruin it. So you really wanna keep that little note in your phone if you're a tag cutter to make sure that you know exactly how to take care of your garment. Another mistake I see people making is washing too frequently. Something to keep in mind about your denim is not to wash your denim too frequently because the color will fade, especially if you're washing in hot water. So keep this in mind if you're washing a pair of dark denim. One time I washed a pair of my dark denim with a pair of little white sleep shorts, and now my sleep shorts are blue because I washed them together. So another rookie mistake is washing your colors with the whites. look, I've done it. I've been guilty. I remember being in college, just throwing all my stuff in the laundry machine because I had to pay for it and didn't care about color, mixing colors and whites and darks and whatever it was. And now I'm a little bit more mindful of it because I have ruined things by washing with my dark denim or with something where the color bled onto another thing. And it just could have easily been avoided if I took the extra step and washed the colors with the colors and the whites with the whites and the darks with the darks. And don't wash your denim unless they are actually dirty. Unless you spilled something on them, they start to smell funny. If you have a stain, I mean, seriously, you can go 6+ months without washing your denim if you don't spill anything on them. I probably go a couple months without washing my denim just because I don't like when the color fades. If they're not dirty, why would I wash them? And to prevent the color from fading as much, you can wash them inside out on low heat and cold water. This is going to prevent bleeding onto other things. It's going to prevent the color from fading as much. It's the worst thing when you buy a pair of beautiful dark wash denim and you've washed them too many times, or you wash them in hot water and the color totally fades out and now you have a pair of medium wash jeans. I don't know about you guys, but I love dark denim, and when they get too faded, they just look gross to me. So that's another reason why I really don't wash my denim a lot. This might sound gross to some of you, but I genuinely do not wash my clothes unless they are dirty. So my gym clothes I will wash after each time, underwear, socks, maybe my pajamas, but my nicer clothes, like my nicer shirts, my jeans, my pants, my sweaters, I do not wash them unless I spill something on them, I sweat in it, or it is genuinely dirty. Like I haven't washed it for months and it's time to go in the washing machine. This just helps your clothes last a lot longer by not washing them as much. So keep all these little tips in mind when it comes to washing. You really want to make sure you read the care instructions, and you might honestly just be overwashing your clothes and it's making them look tattered, worn out, faded, and really just not their best. If you think it might be gross to not wash your clothes every time, you can rest assured knowing Courtney Ryan on YouTube doesn't wash her clothes unless they're dirty. So keep that in mind. Washing plays a huge role in what your clothes look like and how long they last. So guys, that is all I have for today. I hope you all found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to be in the loop for when I release new content. The biggest takeaway I want you guys to get is to make sure you're taking care of the clothes that you buy. I would hate for you all to spend a ton of money on really nice clothes and then ruin them in the washing machine or put them on the wrong hanger and have them not look their best. If you haven't already, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Courtney Christine Ryan. I love connecting with all of you guys on there as well. As always, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all next time.